Namaste students. So today we are dealing with the chapter that is solid state. So in your previous classes you have learned regarding the properties of solids. Later solids has been classified as two types, that is crystalline solids as well as amorphous solids. Crystalline solids again we have classified as ionic crystalline solids, covalent, metallic as well as molecular crystalline solids. Again, molecular crystalline solids we have divided into three types, that is polar, non-polar as well as hydrogen bonded molecular crystalline solids, right? So later you have studied regarding crystal lattice, which is nothing but three-dimensional arrangement of the particle. And if you are studying one part of it in the cell, that will be considered as unit cell. Unit cell we have divided into two types. One is known as primitive unit cell and the second one is known as centered unit cell. Primitive unit cell where the particles are present in only at the corners, okay. Centered unit cell we have divided into three types, that is body centered, face centered as well as end centered. Body centered which represents the particles are present at the corners as well as at the center of the body, okay. And face centered along with the corner particles, in each face the particles are present. End centered in any of opposite side the particle will be present along with the corners, okay. So later we have studied regarding the seven primitive unit cells, which I have given a formula like C2H mono and triclinic. Based on that, you can remember the concept. Okay. Later, the number of unit cell, okay, the particular unit cell which will be having number of particles, right? So if you'll go with the simple or primitive unit cell, it will be having only one particle. Body centered in the sense it is having two particles, as well as face centered in the sense there it will be having total four number of particles. Based on that, you have also learned like how to find out packing efficiency also. Simple unit cell which will have packing efficiency with 52.3% as well as body centered in the sun 68% as well as FCC in the sun 74%. So there it will be more due to the more number of particles which belongs to the cell. And we have also discussed regarding close packing of the solids, right? So how it is in the packing arrangement we have seen with one dimensional, two dimensional as well as three dimensional in terms of voids, right? Okay. So in last class you have learned regarding the imperfection of solids, where we can say like some impurity will be there or some defects will be there, so that it is not perfect. The solid is not there with a perfect form. So it will be caused by point defect as well as line defect, where point defect will in terms of just a point, okay, line defect, so a particular row itself it will be like there in terms of as a defect, right? So now point defect we have divided into three types. One is known as stoichiometric point defect. Again, stoichiometric point defect we have divided into four types, that is vacancy defect, interstitial defect, Schottky defect as well as Frankel defect. These are the four important types, okay. Again, non-stoichiometric defect, so that has been divided into two types. One is metal deficiency defect and another is metal excess defect, which is again divided as, or it is due to the presence of extra cation in interstitial side as well as less number of anion in the sense anionic vacancy. And the last one is impurity. Due to the presence of some impurity, the defects will be seen in crystal lattice, okay, or solid. So that will be considered as imperfection. So in today's class, we will be learning regarding the topic, which is nothing but electrical properties of solids as well as magnetic properties of solids. Okay, so these two are the last concept which is considered this chapter. Okay. So now what is mean by electrical properties of solids, which says that the solids will conduct electricity, okay. So how it conducts electricity, on what manner it conducts electricity, okay. What are the types which belongs to this? So that will be considered as electrical conductance or electrical properties of solids. Again, so this will be mainly based on electrical conductance, okay. So now we have divided this as, okay, based on the electrical conductance of solids, we have divided into three types, okay. So the first one is known as conductor. Conductors. And the second one is known as insulator. And the third one is known as semiconductors. The first one is known as conductors, insulators and semiconductors. So now what is mean by conductors? Conductors are nothing but the substance which will conduct electricity. Okay, so that will be considered as conductors. Okay, which helps to consider electricity. You know the metals which helps to conduct electricity. So conductors, when we say, generally we are going to take examples with metals because it helps to conduct electricity, right? So any of the metal you can take, iron, copper. Okay, so any metal you can take it over here, so because it helps to conduct electricity, right? Okay, so now insulators means what? Okay, insulators which will not conduct electricity. Okay, which is opposite of conductors, which will not be able to conduct electricity, that will be considered as insulators. Example, what we can give? Plastic you can give, rubber you can give, wood can be given, right? So these are our examples for insulators. Now, what is mean by semiconductors? Semi in the sense partially, right? So here partially it conducts electricity, so that will be considered as semiconductors. So the value of semiconductors, it lies between these two, semiconductors as well as insulators. Okay, so here partially it conducts electricity, so that will be considered as semiconductors. So example, if you are taking silicon, germanium, all this things will be taken as semiconductors because partially it helps to conduct electricity. Okay, so this will be considered as semiconductors. So along with this, before going with some of the important properties of these three, okay, so we should know the concept called as band theory. Okay, the electrical conductance, which will be explained better way in this theory. Okay, so that will be considered as band theory. Okay, so now what is mean by band theory? See, in your lower class, in the sense 11th standard, you have learned regarding MOT, right? So there you have learned two energy orbitals will be there. Okay, based on the energy level, we are going to consider as lower energy orbital as bonding molecular orbital, BMO, and the higher energy molecular orbital as antibonding molecular orbital, right? So here also same thing. Okay, so in our orbital, when these electrons are moving, especially conductance of electricity may be due to the presence of electrons, right? Okay, so here what will happen? They shows two bands. Okay, mainly it shows bands. Okay, so one is with the lower energy level and another is with the higher energy level. So lower energy level band will be considered as valence band. Okay, and the higher energy level band will be considered as conduction band. Okay, so remember this. So the lower energy, so this is goes with the lower energy, and the conduction band it goes with higher energy. So if lower energy bands are there, so that will be considered as valence band. If higher energy bands are present, so then it will be considered as conduction band. So always two kinds of band will be seen. Okay, so now what will happen in this band theory concept in terms of these three that we see? Okay, so here if we consider the conductors, so the structure, or it will be there in this manner. See, now the valence band, so it will be like partially or completely filled. Okay, valence band always it is either partially filled or completely filled with electrons. Okay, so now here, because it is lower energy level, right? So consider, now this is your valence band. Okay, so this is your valence band. Okay, now conduction band, you just take the conduction band, this is higher energy band, it will get overlapped with the valence band. Okay, so consider this is the conduction band. Okay, so this is conduction band and this is valence band. So conduction band is overlapped on your valence band. Okay, so here if you see, there is no energy gap. So here there is no gap between the conduction band as well as valence band. So no gap will be seen over here. So what will happen as you will increase the temperature, by that the electrons which is present over here, okay, the electrons which is present over here, it will jump from lower energy level to higher energy level, in the sense from valence band to conduction band it will jump. Okay, so due to this reason, due to the jumping of the electron from lower energy level to higher energy level, due to the attaining of higher energy level of these electrons, it helps to conduct electricity. Due to this reason, the conduction of electricity will be same in conductor. So this is the main reason, so that it goes with conductors. Okay, so due to this reason, it helps to conduct electricity, because electrons are jumping from lower level to higher energy level. Okay, so why this is? Because here there is no energy gap between this. Okay, so between valence bond as well as conduction band, so there the energy gap won't be seen. Due to that reason, so electron can jump from lower energy to higher energy when you increase the temperature. Okay, so now when we go with the insulator, so here how the structure will be seen. See here, consider this is your valence band. Okay, so this is valence band as well as this is the conduction band. Okay, so if you see with the insulator, why it will not conduct electricity? Okay, so electrical conductance, why it is not possible with the insulator? This is the main reason. So there the valence bond as well as conduction bond, if you see, there is much energy gap between these two. There is a lot of gap that will be present between the valence bond as well as conduction, band. Okay, so which will be called as forbidden zone. Which will be known as forbidden zone or forbidden gap. Okay, the much energy gap, more energy gap is present between valence band as well as conduction band. Okay, so due to this reason, it is difficult. If you increase temperature also, what will happen? It is difficult to jump the electrons from your lower energy to higher energy. Okay, so it will not jump from lower energy to higher energy. If the electrons are not jumping, in a sense, it will not conduct electricity. So this is the reason, so that insulator will not conduct electricity because of this fact here. Okay, so now if you go with the semiconductors, you know here the partial conductance is possible with your semiconductors, right? So if you go with the diagram or the structure, how it is present, so consider now this is your valence band, okay, and here, so consider this is the conduction band. So between valence band as well as conduction band, okay, so there will be gap. Okay, here also the gap will be present between these two, but the gap which is present between these two is very less when you compare with your insulator. Okay, so here what will happen, as you will increase the temperature, there is possibility that electron can jump from lower energy to higher energy, but not with the same rate of your conductors, because then there is no gap, so that electrons are easily can jump from lower energy to higher energy. But here it takes some energy. Why? Because the gap is present between those, right? Okay, so the rate would be same as conductor. So we can say here the partial conductance will be seen in semiconductor. The reason, because valence band as well as conductor, band, if you can consider, there is little of gap. Okay, small gap is present between semiconductors. Due to this reason, it conducts electricity. Okay, in partial manner. Okay, so completely it won't conduct electricity. Partially it will conduct electricity. So this is regarding semiconductors. Okay, so write it down. Okay, copy down as it is. So very important, back to you. So next we are going to see the types of semiconductor. So particularly we are going to take semiconductors. So semiconductors we have divided into two types. Semiconductor means what? Partially which will conduct electricity, right? So now here the semiconductors we have divided into two types. So the first one is known as intrinsic semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductor, and the second one is known as extensive semiconductor. So these are the two types of semiconductors. Okay, so intrinsic semiconductor and extensive semiconductor. So first we will see what is mean by intrinsic semiconductor. So intrinsic semiconductor is nothing but here the substance which will be present with a pure form. Okay, there is no impurity in intrinsic semiconductor. So it will be there as pure form. For example, example of silicon, germanium. Okay, so which is nothing but semiconductors, right? So now here I'll take the examples of silicon and okay? So how it is arranged? Silicon. See, this kind of arrangement will be seen with your conductors, okay, with your semiconductors. So now here, what will happen? See, I'll have an example of silicon. So in this big arrangement of the particle, it will be seen, okay, atom will be seen in the remaining semiconductors. So now here, what will happen? Obviously, semiconductors, as I told, their movement of electrons should be there, right? Okay. So here, the movement of electrons will be seen in this way. In the sense, whole surface, the electrons are degenerated. Okay. So due to that reason, it can help to conduct electricity without adding of any impurity or without presence of any impurity. If the semiconductors are present, so that will be considered as intrinsic semiconductor. So this is there with pure form. Okay, so this is there with pure form by itself, by donating with the electrons. In the sense, those electrons, the electrons is present over here, that electrons will be like freely moving. Okay, so it is, it will help to conduct electricity in the case of your intrinsic semiconductor. So how it will go, that movement will be seen according to Bank theory, just have explained. On that basis only, from lower energy to higher energy, the electron will jump, so that it will help to conduct electricity. So this will be seen the intrinsic semiconductor. Eccentric semiconductor means what? Here a special character will be seen, which will be called as doping. Okay. Now, what is mean by doping? Here, what we are doing is, see, you know, semiconductors means what? It is partially, like partially it will help to conduct electricity. Now you want to increase the conductivity of those semiconductors. Okay. So what you can do? You can increase the temperature. But semiconductors, in the sense, obviously, like partially it will conduct electricity. Still you want to increase the temperature. Conductivity. Other than temperature, what you can, in which way you can, increase the conductivity. So that will be explained by doping. Okay. So now here what will happen, we are going to add some of the impurity to the intrinsic semiconductor. Okay, we are going to add some of the impurity to the intrinsic semiconductor so that will help to increase the conductivity of the particular solid. Okay, so now doping means what? Doping is nothing but you are going to add particular impure substance. Okay, so addition of impure substances to increase the conductivity will be considered as doping. Okay, write down addition of impure substance to increase conductivity. Okay, so what kind of substance we are going to add here? So here mainly pentavalent as well as the trivalent atoms. Okay, so those atoms will be added as an impure substance to the intrinsic semiconductor. Trivalent as well as pentavalent. So when you add trivalent as well as pentavalent by that, it will help to conduct electricity in faster way, in sense to the increasing order. Okay, so here on that basis we have divided this eccentric semiconductor as two types. One is known as p type. Okay, so all the classes we have studied regarding this p type, and the second type is known as n type. So p is nothing but positive type and n is nothing but negative type. Okay, so here in this case what will happen? So if I take intrinsic semiconductor, if I take silicon, Okay, now this is your 8 and 6 and 8 and 8. It's a very pure form, right? Okay. So now here what will happen? In P type, okay, if I want to generate P type, by then I'm supposed to take group 13 elements. Okay, in a sense, where I will get trivalent. Okay, trivalent atoms I'm supposed to take. Three valency I'm supposed to get. Okay. So those kind of atoms I'm supposed to take. Where it is present in group 13, it is present, right? Okay. So which of the elements will be present? Boys, all, game, tablet, right? Boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, as well as thallium. So I'll just take any one of the example I can take. Now I'll take aluminium. Okay. So I'll replace one of the silicon by aluminium. Okay. So I have replaced silicon by aluminium. So here what will happen when you replace? See, this aluminium is trivalent. In the sense, three valence it is having. So here one of the valence, in the sense valence electron, it will go for bonding with the silicon. Another valence electron, it will go for bonding with the silicon. Another electron, it will go for bonding with this electron. So you just have three valences. But if you will go with silicon, this is tetravalent, four valences. So that it forms four, four bonds around it, it is possible. If you go with aluminium, it is trivalent. So only three bonds are possible with aluminium. So here fourth bond is not possible with the aluminium, between aluminium as well as silicon. Now silicon, the electron, whatever it is having, so that will be made with silicon itself. Okay. So here, third bond is, fourth bond is not possible. So due to that reason, what it will do? It will produce a hole. Okay. So here it produces a hole. Okay. So now here what will happen? See, to make this hole stable, the adjacent silicon, it gives its electron to this. Okay. So that when it gives this one of the electron, one more electron here, so that bond formation takes place over here. So here bond will be formed, but here one electron is less. So the formation of hole can be seen over here. So this will continue. Okay. For this, again the adjacent silicon it gives electron. Again hole will be seen in this way. Okay. So it happens in whole solid structure, whole crystallization, you can see with this kind of structure. In a sense, continuous hole formation will be seen with the particular electron. So this hole will help to conduct electricity. This hole will help to degenerate the electricity in p-type. Okay. So holes in the sense positive kind of the type of structure will be seen. For that reason, in the sense the movement or degeneration will be seen with the structure crystal lattice. So this will be considered as p-type. So next, what is n-type? If I will take the same silicon itself, I take, in a sense I will take intrinsic semiconductor itself. Okay. So now here what will happen? You are supposed to take pentavalent atoms. Okay, take pentavalent elements. So which is pentavalent element? I can take group 15th element. Okay, so group 15th element, pentavalent in the sense I should get 5 valence electrons, right? So pentavalent electrons, element I am supposed to take for N type of semiconductor. So which of all elements will come? Nitrogen with passbook, we go for state pair. Okay, yes, 5, right? So now nitrogen, phosphorus, LCM, then here bismuth. Okay, so now here what will happen? Nitrogen, phosphorus, antimony, bismuth, right? So now here what will happen in this group 15, in the sense pentavalent, 5 valence electron I am supposed to take. So now I will take with the example of phosphorus. Any example you can take, so it goes with N type. So now I will replace one of the silicon with phosphorus. Okay, so one of the silicon I will just replace with the phosphorus. So now what will happen? Phosphorus, in the sense, what is the valence electron? That is 5. In the sense, it needs 5 bonds around it. So one of the bond is possible with this silicon, and there is this, and there is this, and fourth bond is possible with another silicon. And fifth electron, it is remaining free now, because there is no possible that it will, it can form bond with the silicon. So now it is free electrons. Okay, so free electrons are possible in the case of phosphate. Okay, so to balance this silicon, it gives electron towards this, so that here electron will be free over there by that. So again, this silicon, in the sense, it will continue in this way. In whole crystal lattice, the moment regeneration of the electrons will be seen, so that which will help to conduct electricity. Okay, so in the sense, the conductivity will increase. Okay, so due to the formation of the hole as well as electron, in the sense, it is negatively charged, right? So which will be considered as n type of semiconductor. So due to the presence of hole, okay, by the addition of group 13 elements, as well as the formation of electrons, in the sense free electrons, due to addition of group 15 elements, in the sense trivalent as well as pentavalent element, okay, the conductivity we are going to increase, okay, so in the crystal lattice or in any solid. So that will be considered as semiconductor. So semiconductor will be having two types, intrinsic as well as extrinsic. So this is there in the pure form. To help the to increase the conductivity, we are going to add some of the impure form to this. So when we add any impure form, that will be considered as doping. Okay, so when we add impure form, if it is trivalent atom, if you are adding in the sense which produces hole, that will be considered as p-type. And if you are adding pentavalent element, so that it produces free electron, and that will be considered as n type of semiconductor. Okay, just write it down, copy it down.